Hi, welcome back to our review of the mathematical foundations necessary for applying deep learning to natural language processing. I'm Jordan Boyd Graber, an associate professor at the University of Maryland. I'm fortunate to be joined by my former student, Alvin.
Hi, I'm Alvin Grissom. I'm an assistant professor of computer science at Haverford College. So we've already talked about Python functions. These correspond to mathematical functions, and the most important functions we'll use are probability distributions. Today we'll talk about the two most important distributions and the notation we'll use to describe.
In Python, a function is something that takes a variable as an input and gives some output. How is that different from a mathematical function?
It's not all that different. In fact, it's exactly the same. Where it might look a little bit different is in how we write it.
Okay, so let's take a simple function that doubles a number. What might that look like in both math notation and Python?
A mathematical function is typically written as a single letter, like F or G, while a Python function is written with a name.
Okay, great. Are there other ways that people write a function or describe a function?
Yeah, sometimes we'll provide some sample values or to plot what the function looks like. And so for example, here's an exponential function. You can see that its values increase rapidly.
Okay, so what can you do with a function?
So let's go back to the doubling function. We can take the absolute value of the function, which we signify using these two vertical bars on either side of the x, making its output always positive.
Oh, okay, this is like mirroring the function across the x-axis. Can we mirror it across the y-axis?
No, because a function can only have one output for a given input.
I guess that makes sense. Just like a Python program, you can't have two return values, you only get to return once. What does that have to do with the y-axis?
Well, if you draw a vertical line, then it can only pass through the function once.
We can't flip it across the y-axis. Could we make it look like this?
Yeah, that's just negating the input. Here's what negating would look like for the exponential function.
These are relatively simple functions that people are already familiar with. We're probably going to need some more advanced functions, aren't we?
Fortunately, we can make more complicated functions out of simpler functions. For example, we can compare several functions. Let's take the functions f, g, and h.
Okay, if f is the exponential function we already talked about, that's easy. G is just adding 1 to a number, but what's 1 over x?
This is when you divide 1 by a number.
Okay. This is where we diverge from a Python program. You can't divide by zero.
Well, just like a Python program, we can write the function, but we have problems when we get around zero. Mathematically, it's no problem. It's just what's called an asymptote at zero.
But a computer can't actually use this function at zero, right? It would cause problems.
Exactly. Even if you don't directly divide by zero, the numbers would get so large that it would cause problems. So let's compose these functions to create a new function that we'll be seeing quite a bit of in the course.
When we compose functions, this just means we take the output of one function to be the input of another function, right? One way to do this might be to take the exponential function of negative x to be the input of 1 over x.
Yeah, you could write it in Python like this.
Okay, so problem solved. The exponential function is always positive, so this never gets to zero.
Not exactly. This is just the exponential function again.
Huh? How?
So e, or x, of negative x, is the same as 1 over e to the x. And 1 over 1 over e to the x is just e to the x.
Ah, okay. This would still get too big too quickly then. Okay, let's prevent 1 over x from getting too small. Let's just add 1 before we pass it in. So first negative x, then add 1, then divide by that.
Exactly. The function you just put together is called the logistic function. It's shaped like an S. It goes from 0 to 1 and is 0.5 at 0. It can also take any number as input.
If it goes from 0 to 1, it sounds like a probability.
Yes, exactly. That's one interpretation. And next time, we'll talk about more functions that we can use to express probabilities.
If you want to see more videos like this, check the video description for the course that comes from the link down below. You can then see the context and the correct order for watching these videos. YouTube will gleefully show you stuff in the wrong order. If you want other people to see this video, provide a big gradient to the recommendation algorithm by clicking the like and subscribe button down below.